This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Iodine is a chemical element with symbol I and atomic number 53, the heaviest of the stable halogens. It exists as a lustrous, purple-black metallic solid at a standard conditions that sublimes readily to form a violet gas. The elemental form was discovered by the French chemist Bernard Courtois in 1811. It was named 2 years later by Joseph Louis Gay-Lussac from this property, after the Greek iodes. Violet-colored iodine occurs in many oxidation states, including iodide I-, iodate IO-3. And the various periodate anions. It is the least abundant of the stable halogens, being the 61st most abundant element. It is even less abundant than the so-called rare earths. It is the heaviest essential element. Iodine is found in the thyroid hormones. Iodine deficiency affects about 2 billion people and is the leading preventable cause of intellectual disabilities. The dominant producers of iodine today are Chile and Japan. Iodine and its compounds are primarily used in nutrition due to its high atomic number and ease of attachment to organic compounds. It has also found favor as a non-toxic radiocontrast material because of the specificity of its uptake by the human body. Radioactive isotopes of iodine can also be used to treat thyroid cancer. Iodine is also used as a catalyst in the industrial production of acetic acid and some polymers contents. 1 History 2 Properties 21 Isotopes 3 Chemistry and Compounds 31 Hydrogen Iodide 32 Other Binary Iodides 33 Iodine Halides 34 Iodine Oxides and Oxoacids 35 Polyiodine Compounds 36 Organoiodine Compounds 4 Occurrence and Production 5 Applications 51 Analysis 52 Disinfectants 53 Medicine 54 Others 6 Biological Role 61 Dietary Intake 62 Deficiency 7 Toxicity 71 Occupational Exposure 72 Allergic Reactions 8 References 9 Bibliography History In 1811, iodine was discovered by French chemist Bernard Courtois, who was born to a manufacturer of saltpeter, an essential component of gunpowder at that time of the Napoleonic Wars. Saltpeter was in great demand in France. Saltpeter produced from French niter beds required sodium carbonate, which could be isolated from seaweed collected on the coasts of Normandy and Britain. To isolate the sodium carbonate, seaweed was burned and the ash washed with water. The remaining waste was destroyed by adding sulfuric acid. Courtois once added excessive sulfuric acid and a cloud of purple vapor rose. He noted that the vapor crystallized on cold surfaces, making dark crystals. Courtois suspected that this material was a new element but lacked funding to pursue it further. Courtois gave samples to his friends Charles Bernard de Sormes 1777-1838 and Nicolas Clement 1779-1841. To continue research, he also gave some of the substance to chemist Joseph Louis Gay-Lussac 1778-1850, and to physicist André-Marie Ampère 1775-1836. On 29 November 1813, de Sormes and Clement made Courtois' discovery public. They described the substance to a meeting of the Imperial Institute of France on 6 December. Gay-Lussac announced that the new substance was either an element or a compound of oxygen. It was Gay-Lussac who suggested the name iode, from the Greek word ioiades, ioiades for violet, because of the color of iodine vapor. Ampère had given some of his sample to English chemist Humphrey Davy 1778-1829, who experimented on the substance and noted its similarity to chlorine. Davy sent a letter dated 10 December to the Royal Society of London stating that he had identified a new element. Arguments erupted between Davy and Gay-Lussac over who identified iodine first, but both scientists acknowledged Courtois as the first to isolate the element properties violet iodine vapor in a round-bottomed flask. Iodine is the fourth halogen, being a member of group 17 in the periodic table, below fluorine, chlorine, and bromine. It is the heaviest stable member of its group. The scarce and fugitive fifth halogen, the radioactive astatine, is not well studied due to its expense and inaccessibility in large quantities, but appears to show various unusual properties due to relativistic effects. Iodine has an electron configuration of 4d105s 25p5, with the 7 Electrons in the fifth and outermost shell being its valence electrons like the other halogens, it is one electron short of a full octet and is hence a strong oxidizing agent, reacting with many elements in order to complete its outer shell. Although in keeping with periodic trends, it is the weakest oxidizing agent among the stable halogens, it has the lowest electronegativity among them, just 266 on the Pauling scale. Compare fluorine, chlorine, and bromine at 398, 316, and 296 respectively. Astatine continues the trend with an electronegativity of 22. Elemental iodine hence forms diatomic molecules with chemical formula I2, where two iodine atoms share a pair of electrons in order to each achieve a stable octet for themselves. At high temperatures, these diatomic molecules reversibly dissociate a pair of iodine atoms. Similarly, the iodide anion, I-, is the strongest reducing agent among the stable halogens, being the most easily oxidized back to diatomic I2. Astatine goes further, being indeed unstable as at minus and readily oxidized to at zero or at, although the existence of at 2 is not settled. The halogens darken in color as the group is descended. Fluorine is a very pale yellow gas, chlorine is greenish yellow, and bromine is a reddish brown volatile liquid. Iodine conforms to the prevailing trend, being a shiny black crystalline solid that melts at 114. Depending on how metallic it turns out to be specifically, the violet color of iodine gas results from the electron transition between the highest occupied antibonding pi G molecular orbital and the lowest vacant antibonding sigma U molecular orbital. Elemental iodine is slightly soluble in water, with 1 gram dissolving in 3450. Reactivity of the halogen structure of solid iodine. The interhalogen bond in diiodine is the weakest of all the halogens. As such, 1% of a sample of gaseous iodine at atmospheric pressure is dissociated into iodine atoms at 575. Of the 37 known isotopes of iodine, only one occurs in nature, iodine-127. The others are radioactive and have half-lives too short to be primordial. As such, iodine is monoisotopic and its atomic weight is known to great precision, as it is a constant of nature. The longest-lived of the radioactive isotopes of iodine is iodine-129, which has a half-life of 157. Them have medical applications involving the thyroid gland, where the iodine that enters the body is stored and concentrated. Iodine-123 has a half-life of 13 hours and decays by electron capture to tellurium-123, emitting gamma radiation. It is used in nuclear medicine imaging, including single photon emission computed tomography SPECT and X-ray computed tomography X-ray CT scans. Iodine-125 has a half-life of 59 days, decaying by electron capture to tellurium-125 and emitting low-energy gamma radiation, the second longest-lived iodine radioisotope. It has uses in biological assays, nuclear medicine imaging, and in radiation therapy as brachytherapy to treat a number of conditions, including prostate cancer, uveal melanomas, and brain tumors. Finally, iodine-131, with a half-life of 8 days, beta decays to an excited state of stable xenon-131 that then converts to the ground state by emitting gamma radiation. It is a common fission product and thus is present in high levels in radioactive fallout. It may then be absorbed through contaminated food, and will also accumulate in the thyroid as it decays. It may cause damage to the thyroid. The primary risk from exposure to high levels of iodine-131 is the chance occurrence of radiogenic thyroid cancer in later life. Other risks include the possibility of non-cancerous growths and thyroiditis. The usual means of protection against the negative effects of iodine-131 is by saturating the thyroid gland with stable iodine-127 in the form of potassium iodide tablets, taken daily for optimal prophylaxis. However, iodine-131 may also be used for medicinal purposes in radiation therapy. For this very reason, when tissue destruction is desired after iodine uptake by the tissue, iodine-131 is also used as a radioactive tracer chemistry and compounds. Though it is the least reactive of the halogens, iodine is still one of the more reactive elements. For example, while chlorine gas will halogenate carbon monoxide, nitrogen monoxide, and sulfur dioxide to phosgene, nitrosyl chloride, and sulfonyl chloride respectively, iodine will not do so. Furthermore, iodine chlorination of metals tends to result in lower oxidation states than chlorination or bromination. For example, rhenium metal reacts with chlorine to form rhenium hexachloride, but with bromine it only forms rhenium pentabromide, and iodine can achieve only rhenium tetraiodide by the same token. However, since iodine has the lowest ionization energy among the halogens and is the most easily oxidized of them, it has a more significant cationic chemistry, and its higher oxidation states are rather more stable than those of bromine and chlorine. For example, in iodine heptafluoride hydrogen iodide, the simplest compound of iodine is hydrogen iodide. It is a colorless gas that reacts with oxygen to give water and iodine. Although it is useful in iodination reactions in the laboratory, it does not have large-scale industrial uses, unlike the other hydrogen halides. Commercially, it is usually made by reacting iodine with hydrogen sulfide or hydrazine, 2I2N2H4H2O. Solvent, because its boiling point is low, it has a small liquid range, its dielectric constant is low, and it does not dissociate appreciably into H2I and Hi-2 ions. The latter, in any case, are much less stable than the bifluoride ions HF-2 due to the very weak hydrogen bonding between hydrogen and iodine, though it salts with very large and weakly polarizing cations such as Cs and Nr4R equals Me, et Bun may still be isolated anhydrous hydrogen iodide as a poor solvent, only able to dissolve small molecular compounds such as nitrosyl chloride and phenol, or salts with very low lattice energies such as tetraalkylammonium halides. Other binary iodides. Nearly all elements in the periodic table form binary iodides. The exceptions are decidedly in the minority and stem in each case from one of three causes: extreme inertness and reluctance to participate in chemical reactions, the noble gases, extreme nuclear instability hampering chemical investigation before decay and transmutation, many of the heaviest elements beyond bismuth, and having an electronegativity higher than iodine's oxygen and the first three halogens, so that the resultant binary compounds are formally not iodides but rather oxides or halides of iodine. Given the large size of the iodide anion and iodine's weak oxidizing power, high oxidation states are difficult to achieve in binary iodides, the maximum known being in the pentiodides. Of niobium, tantalum, and protactinium, iodides can be made by reaction of an element or its oxide, hydroxide, or carbonate with hydroiodic acid, and then dehydrated by mildly high temperatures combined with either low pressure or anhydrous hydrogen iodide gas. These methods work best when the iodide product is stable to hydrolysis. Otherwise, the possibilities include high temperature oxidative iodination of the element with iodine or hydrogen iodide, high temperature iodination of a metal oxide or other halide by iodine, a volatile metal halide, carbon tetraiodide, or an organic iodide. For example, molybdenum-EV oxide reacts with aluminium-E iodide at 230. MXN of the same element, because the electrostatic forces of attraction between the cations and anions are weakest for the large iodide anion. In contrast, covalent iodides tend to instead have the highest melting and boiling points among the halides of the same element, since iodine is the most polarizable of the halogens and, having the most electrons among them, can contribute the most to van der Waals forces naturally. Exceptions abound in intermediate iodides where one trend gives way to the other. Similarly, solubilities in water of predominantly ionic iodides, e.g. potassium and calcium, are the greatest among ionic halides of that element, while those of covalent iodides, e.g. silver, are the lowest of that element. In particular, silver iodide is very insoluble in water, and its formation is often used as a qualitative test for iodine-iodine halides. The halogens form many binary, diamagnetic interhalogen compounds with stoichiometries XY, XY3, XY5, and XY7, where X is heavier than Y, and iodine is no exception. Iodine forms all three possible diatomic interhalogens, a trifluoride and trichloride, as well as a pentafluoride and, exceptionally among the halogens, a heptafluoride. Numerous cationic and anionic derivatives are also characterized, such as the wine red or bright orange compounds of ICl2 and the dark brown or purplish-black compounds of diiodine monochloride. Apart from these, some pseudohalides are also known, such as cyanogen iodide ICN, iodine thiocyanate ISCN, and iodine azide. In3 iodine monochloride. Iodine monofluoride, if is unstable at room temperature and disproportionates very readily and irreversibly to iodine and iodine pentafluoride, and thus cannot be obtained pure. It can be synthesized from the reaction of iodine with fluorine gas in trichlorofluoromethane at -45. iodination being the main reaction, since now heterolytic fission of the I-Cl bond occurs and I attacks phenol as an electrophile. However, iodine monobromide tends to brominate phenol even in tetrachloromethane solution because it tends to dissociate into its elements in solution, and bromine is more reactive than iodine when liquid. Iodine monochloride and iodine monobromide dissociate into I2X and X-2N ions, thus they are significant conductors of electricity and can be used as ionizing solvents. Iodine trifluoride IF3 is an unstable yellow solid that decomposes above -28. Iodine pentafluoride IF5, a colorless, volatile liquid, is the most thermodynamically stable iodine fluoride, and can be made by reacting iodine with fluorine gas at room temperature. It is a fluorinating agent, but is mild enough to store in glass apparatus again. Slight electrical conductivity is present in the liquid state because of dissociation to IF4 and IF-6. The pentagonal bipyramidal iodine heptafluoride IF7 is an extremely powerful fluorinating agent, behind only chlorine trifluoride, chlorine pentafluoride, and bromine pentafluoride among the interhalogens. It reacts with almost all the elements even at low temperatures, fluorinates pyrex glass to form iodineV oxyfluoride IOF5, and sets carbon monoxide on fire. Iodine oxides and oxoacids. Structure of iodine pentoxide. Iodine oxides are the most stable of all the halogen oxides, because of the strong IO bonds resulting from the large electronegativity difference between iodine and oxygen, and they have been known for the longest time. The stable, white, hygroscopic iodine pentoxide I2O5 has been known since its formation in 1813 by Gay-Lussac and Davy. It is most easily made by the dehydration of iodic acid HiO3, which it is the anhydride of. It will quickly oxidize carbon monoxide completely to carbon dioxide at room temperature, and is thus a useful reagent in determining carbon monoxide concentration. It also oxidizes nitrogen oxide, ethylene, and hydrogen sulfide. It reacts with sulfur trioxide and peroxidisulfuryl difluoride S2O6F2 to form salts of the iodyl cation, and is reduced by concentrated sulfuric acids to iodosyl salts involving it. May be fluorinated by fluorine, bromine trifluoride, sulfur tetrafluoride, or chloral fluoride, resulting iodine pentafluoride, which also reacts with iodine pentoxide, giving iodine F oxyfluoride, IOF3. A few other less stable oxides are known, notably I409 and I204. Their structures have not been determined, but reasonable guesses are IIIIIVO33 and minus respectively. Standard reduction potentials for aqueous I species: E degree couple A equals 1 acid, E degree couple AOH minus equals 1 base I2, I-0535I2, I-0535 HOI, I-0987 EO-, I-0486 IO-3065. More important are the four oxoacids: hypoiodous acid HIO, iodous acid HIO2, iodic acid HIO3, and periodic acid HIO4 or H5IO6. When iodine dissolves in aqueous solution, the following reactions occur: I2H2OHIOH I- acidic solution, I2-2O-IO-H2O I- alkaline solution. Hypoiodous acid is unstable to disproportionation. The hypoiodite ions thus form disproportionate immediately to give iodide and iodate. 3IO-2I-IO-3 iodous acid and iodide are even less stable and only exist as a fleeting intermediate in the oxidation of iodide to iodate, if at all. Iodates are by far the most important of these compounds, which can be made by oxidizing alkali metal iodides with oxygen at 600. Reacts the quickest. Many periodates are known, including not only the expected tetrahedral IO-4, but also square pyramidal IO3-5, octahedral orthoperiodate IO5-6, 2-4-, and I2O4-9. They are usually made by oxidizing alkaline sodium iodate electrochemically with lead of oxide as the anode, or by chlorine gas, IO-6-3H2O2E-IO-3-6-0-Cl2IO5-6-2Cl-3H2O. They are thermodynamically and kinetically powerful oxidizing agents, quickly oxidizing Mn2 to MnO-4, and cleaving glycols, alpha-dictones, alpha-ketols, alpha-aminoalcohols, and alpha-diamines. Orthoperiodate especially stabilizes high oxidation states among metals because of its very High negative charge of -5 orthoperiodic acid, H5IO6, is stable, and dehydrates at 100. I3 and centrosymmetric C2H green or black I5, known in the ASF-6 and aluminium chloride -4 salts among others. The only important polyiodide anion in aqueous solution is linear triiodide, I-3. Its formation explains why the solubility of iodine in water may be increased by the addition of potassium iodide solution, I2I-I-3 Keq equals approximately 700 at 20. Structure of the oxidizing agent 2-iodoxybenzoic acid organoiodine compounds have been fundamental in the development of organic synthesis, such as in the Hoffman elimination of amines, the Williamson ether synthesis, the Wurtz coupling reaction, and in Grignard reagents. The carbon-iodine bond is a common functional group that forms part of core organic chemistry. Formally, these compounds may be thought of as organic derivatives of the iodide anion. The simplest organoiodine compounds, alkyl iodides, may be synthesized by the reaction of alcohols with phosphorus triiodide. These may then be used in nucleophilic substitution reactions, or for preparing Grignard reagents. The Cl bond is the weakest of all the carbon-halogen bonds due to the minuscule difference in electronegativity between carbon-255 and iodine-266. As such, iodide is the best leaving group among the halogens, to such an extent that many organoiodine compounds turn yellow when stored over time due to decomposition into elemental iodine. As such, they are commonly used in organic synthesis. Because of the easy formation and cleavage of the Cl bond, they are also significantly denser than the other organohalogen compounds. Thanks to the high atomic weight of iodine, a few organic oxidizing agents like the pyridinanes contain iodine in a higher oxidation state than -1, such as 2-iodoxybenzoic acid, a common reagent for the oxidation of alcohols to aldehydes, and iodobenzene dichloride PHICl2, used for the selective chlorination of alkenes and alkynes. One of the more well-known uses of organoiodine compounds is the so-called iodoform test, where iodoform CHI3 is produced by the exhaustive iodination of a methyl ketone or another compound capable of being oxidized to a methyl ketone. As follows, some drawbacks of using organoiodine compounds as compared to organochlorine or organobromine compounds is the greater expense and toxicity of the iodine derivatives. Since iodine is expensive and organoiodine compounds are stronger alkylating agents, for example, iodoacetamide and iodoacetic acid denature proteins by irreversibly alkylating cysteine residues and preventing the reformation of disulfide linkages. Halogen exchange to produce iodoalkanes by the Finkelstein reaction is slightly complicated by the fact that iodide is a better leaving group than chloride or bromide. The difference is nevertheless small enough that the reaction can be driven to completion by exploiting the differential solubility of halide salts, or by using a large excess of the halide salt in the classic Finkelstein reaction. An alkyl chloride or an alkyl bromide is converted to an alkyl iodide by treatment with a solution of sodium iodide in acetone. Sodium iodide is soluble in acetone, and sodium chloride and sodium bromide are not. The reaction is driven toward products by mass action due to the precipitation of the insoluble salt occurrence and production. Iodine is the least abundant of the stable halogens, comprising only 0.46 million of Earth's crustal rocks. Compare, fluorine 544. Dioxide reduces the iodine. The hydrogen iodide high is reacted with chlorine to precipitate the iodine after filtering and purification. The iodine is packed 2HiCl2I22HCl I22H2OSO2 2H2SO4 2HCl2I22HCl. These sources ensure that Chile and Japan are the largest producers of iodine today. Alternatively, the brine may be treated with silver nitrate to precipitate out iodine as silver iodide, which is then decomposed by reaction with iron to form metallic silver and a solution of irony iodide. The iodine may then be liberated by displacement with chlorine. Applications unlike chlorine and bromine, which have one significant main use dwarfing all others, iodine is instead used in many applications of varying importance. About half of all produced iodine goes into various organoiodine compounds, another 15% remains as the pure element, another 15% is used to form potassium iodide, and another 15% for other inorganic iodine compounds. The remaining 5% is for minor uses. Among the major uses of iodine compounds are catalysts, animal feed supplements, stabilizers, dyes, colorants and pigments, pharmaceutical, sanitation from tincture of iodine, photography. Minor uses include smog inhibition, cloud seeding, and various uses in analytical chemistry. Analysis testing a seed for starch with a solution of iodine potassium tetriodomercurate, K2-mercury-4-iodide, is also known as Nessler's reagent. It is often used as a sensitive spot test for ammonia. Similarly, Cu2-mercury-4-iodide is used as a precipitating reagent to test for alkaloids. The iodide and iodate anions are often used for quantitative volumetric analysis, for example in iodometry and the iodine clock reaction, in which iodine also serves as a test for starch, forming a dark blue complex. An aqueous alkaline iodine solution is used in the iodoform test for methyl ketones. The iodine test for starch is still used to detect counterfeit banknotes printed on starch containing paper disinfectants. Elemental iodine is used as a disinfectant either as the element, or as the water-soluble triiodide anion I3- generated in situ by adding iodide to poorly water-soluble elemental iodine. The reverse chemical reaction makes some free elemental iodine available for antisepsis. In the alternative, iodine may be produced from iodophores, which contain iodine complexed with a solubilizing agent. Iodide ion may be thought of loosely as the iodophore in triiodide water solutions. Examples of such preparations include tincture of iodine, iodine in ethanol, or iodine and sodium iodide in a mixture of ethanol and water. Lugol's iodine, iodine and iodide in water alone, forming mostly triiodide. Unlike tincture of iodine, Lugol's iodine has a minimized amount of the free iodine I2 component povidone iodine and iodophore. The antimicrobial action of iodine is quick and works at low concentrations, and thus it is used in operating theaters. Its specific mode of action is unknown. It penetrates into microorganisms and attacks particular amino acids such as cysteine and methionine, nucleotides, and fatty acids, ultimately resulting in cell death. It also has an antiviral action, but nonlipid viruses and parvoviruses are less sensitive than lipid-enveloped viruses. Iodine probably attacks surface proteins of enveloped viruses, and it may also destabilize membrane fatty acids by reacting with unsaturated carbon bonds. Medicine. In medicine, a saturated solution of potassium iodide is used to treat acute thyrotoxicosis. It is also used to block uptake of iodine-131 in the thyroid gland. See isotopes section above. When this isotope is used as part of radiopharmaceuticals such as iobenguane that are not targeted to the thyroid or thyroid-type tissues, iodine-131 usually as iodide is a component of nuclear fallout, and is particularly dangerous owing to the thyroid gland's propensity to concentrate ingested iodine and retain it for periods longer than this isotope's radiological half-life of 8 days for this reason. People who at risk of exposure to environmental radioactive iodine. Iodine-131 in fallout may be instructed to take non-radioactive potassium iodide tablets. The typical adult dose is 1/130. Which support the world's demand for acetic acid. Hydroiodic acid converts the methanol feedstock into methyl iodide, which undergoes carbonylation hydrolysis of the resulting acetyl iodide, regenerates hydroiodic acid and gives acetic acid. Inorganic iodides find specialized uses. Titanium, zirconium, hafnium, and thorium are purified by the Van Arkel process, which involves the reversible formation of the tetriodides of these elements. Silver iodide is a major ingredient to traditional photographic film. Thousands of kilograms of silver iodide are used annually for cloud seeding to induce rain. The organoiodine compound erythrosine is an important food coloring agent. Perfluoroalkyl iodides are precursors to important surfactants, such as perfluorooctane sulfonic acid. Biological role. Main article, iodine in biology. The thyroid system of the thyroid hormones T3 and T4. Iodine is an essential element for life and is the heaviest element commonly needed by living organisms. Lanthanum and the other lanthanides, as well as tungsten, are used by a few microorganisms. It is required for the synthesis of the growth-regulating thyroid hormones thyroxine and triiodothyronine T4 and T3 respectively, named after their number of iodine atoms. A deficiency of iodine leads to decreased production of T3 and T4 and a concomitant enlargement of the thyroid tissue in an attempt to obtain more iodine, causing the disease known as simple goiter. The major form of thyroid hormone in the blood is thyroxine T4, which has a longer half-life than T3 in humans. The ratio of T4 to T3 released into the blood is between 14:1 and 20:1. T4 is converted to the active T3 three to four times more potent than T4 within cells by deiodinases 5 iodinase. These are further processed by decarboxylation iodination and deiodination to produce iodothyronamine T1A and thyronamine T0A. All three isoforms of the deiodinases are selenium-containing enzymes, thus dietary selenium is essential for T3 production. Iodine accounts for 65% of the molecular weight of T4 and 59% of T3 15-20. Years, 130. Ranging between 5,280. Also a problem in certain areas of Europe. Information processing, fine motor skills, and visual problem solving are improved by iodine repletion in moderately iodine-deficient children. Toxicity. Elemental iodine I2 is toxic if taken orally. The lethal dose for an adult human is 30. Eye contact. The Occupational Safety and Health Administration OSHA has set the legal limit permissible exposure limit for iodine exposure in the workplace at 01 ppm 1. Should be questioned and consulted before any containing iodine are administered. References. Carat Standard Atomic Weights 2013 Commission on Isotopic Abundances and Atomic Weights. Carat Magnetic Susceptibility of the Elements and Inorganic Compounds, in Handbook of Chemistry and Physics 81st edition, CRC Press. Carat A. B. Courtois, Bernard 1813 Découverte d'une substance nouvelle dans le verre. Annales de Chimie 88-304. Imperial de France on 29 November 1813, a summary of their announcement appeared in the Gazette Nationale au Le Moniteur Universel of 2 December 1813. C. F. D. Chataway 23 April 1909 The discovery of iodine. The Chemical News.